We were speaking to Jackson's father. He is saying so strong and determined to see that this intersection is safer for everyone. And he is on a mission to make sure that these changes get into place this spring, even though it won't come in time to save his son. And at the same time, this project has been on hold for several months. So we took our questions to the county to get them answered.
Now I know that life's going to be easy because if I can make it through this, I'm good.
Tonight, a father's heart is broken. Jason Crabtree, unable to process his new reality that his 15-year-old son's life was lost in an instant. Jackson Crabtree was struck and killed by a school bus Tuesday morning at the busy intersection of Medulla and Pipkin Roads.
I just give him a big old hug and tell him how proud of him I was, but he knew that.
Jackson was a sophomore at the Central Florida Aerospace Academy. He was passionate about the JROTC and had his sights set on becoming a pilot. But Tuesday morning, his life was cut short. His daily path across Pipkin Road, known to be dangerous. And it's been the focal point of community frustrations for years.
There's been so many car accidents in that intersection, and that's why as a community we've been asking for that light for almost over a year now.
The intersection is right at the entrance of the Riverstone Housing Development. According to an agreement with the city in 2018, it's the developer's responsibility to install traffic signals. Today, Polk County's Road and Drainage Director addressing the delays.
The electronic equipment that is required to do those signals, the cabinets and those types of things, are currently experiencing anywhere from, we've been told, a year to 18 months delay.
But now the Crabtree family has to bear the burden of that delay.
What steps can we take to have all the kids make it to school and make it home from school in one piece?
And that is a question that so many people in the community are also asking tonight. The county says that this light should be installed by this spring. But again, it's just a matter of time before we see what the county will do in the meantime. As for Lakeland Police, they say they will be sending extra patrols to this area, especially before and after the school day. Reporting live in Lakeland, Lenny Sue Hall, 8 on your side.